gonna put some polyurethane on this little butcher block right here. While a little man eats a banana. And we're just trying to protect the wood a little bit if we ever spill anything on it. to the composting bin out here. I'm just going to turn it up a little bit. It's not a pretty compost bin, but it's really kept all the critters out, so that's the main point. If you notice the orange rinds right there, they're really hard to break down, so you really don't want to put a lot of orange rinds in your composting bin. Hey guys, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to replace that part right there with this union right here. The reason is you could see when I joined those two right there, they're not 100% straight and I don't want anything to break later on down the line. And if I had to do any repairs, I could just unhook this. It's just screws in on each side. So I'm going to go ahead and cut that, put this together. Hopefully it straightens out a little bit and then I could start backfilling this portion right here. I like about these cutters right here, they're easy to use and you get a really good straight cut when you use them because this part just fits right around the pipe. I think the biggest you could cut is a 2-inch pipe, which is what this is. So this application is perfect. So now that I have this piece out, you know, I could line this up to where it's really nice and straight, to where it looks good, and we don't have to worry about it breaking in the future. Side. Stuff's in there. And this you could slide right through it. Now, so I can move this up quite a bit and it won't be an issue. Slides in now. So it's going to pull that rubber gasket back tight up here so it doesn't leak water there. And then same thing down here. Parts all repaired now. So now I'm ready to backfill this section right here with rock, covered up, make sure it's really nice and good. But first we'll pull this yard fabric completely up and in there. Wrap that whole pipe and then we'll backfill it with rock. Okay, we have the gray water and French drain backfilled a little bit with rock. Later on, we're going to remove all this dirt. I'm just going to keep rock all over the top of it. Nothing heavy is going to drive over this pipe. We'll just be walking across it. But next time we're out here, we're going to be going underneath the cabin right there, which is going to be super fun. I guess with buckets of rock and just spreading it all the way to the back, it's 16 feet back. And then there's another spot in the back of the cabin where we're going to connect a French drain as well. What you doing there, Dad? Why don't you tell me what you're making right there?
I'm just doing whatever my son tells me to do.
So right here, we're making the part of the wood that's going to cover the walkthrough into the kitchen and into the other portion of the addition. So we're taking some pieces of the tongue and groove. We're cutting it to 5.5 inches, and then we're going to put it on the router and round off the edges. That way there's a smooth finish. We just didn't want a 90 degree finish because of the little kids running around. We don't want anybody splitting their heads on corners.